galumuwa mama china seme uko chitira wachite keduzi akosibulumo kidunu konsibulumo eze nikwe bikolota lutazia mama china sa keduzi akosibulumo kidunu konsibulumo kidunu konsibulumo keduzi akosibulumo eze nikwe lutanu lutazia mama china sa. Wachite keduzi akosibulumo kidunu konsibulumo eze nikwe bikolota lutazia mama china sa.
I didn't know you were here already.
Do you know the difference between a lady that has succeeded and the one that has failed? The difference is in the decision they take. I look at you and I see poverty. Poverty is all over you. Poverty is your problem. And that problem can end here and now. If you decide to give me what I want. I am a man that sits on a mountain of money. And without me, nothing happens.
Sir, you're my last hope. The news is everywhere that you help indigent students that cannot pay their fees.
And you think I help them just like that? My name is Olwo Olie. You get paid if you walk.
Sir, tell me whatever you want me to do and I will do it. Just name it, I will do it. Every other student has paid for the final examination. I'm the only one remaining.
And you will remain like that until you know exactly what to do. What work can you really do here? What work can you really do? What can you do for me? You know exactly what to do. If you decide and do it, I'll give you all the money. Simply make up your mind, that's all.
My mother told me that you are very close to my father. Why would you want to defile your friend's daughter?
Defile? Did I hear you say defile? If that's it, it's all you want to say. And there is nothing else you can say. That's the door.
He didn't give you any money.
He made it point blank that he was going to take advantage of me before giving me the money.
Hey, God! Alole wanted to sleep with you? Hey, Chineke, no. Waka, waka, waka.
Mama, listen.
Hey, wa. Wa.
Mama, it is my cross to bear.
Hey.
Okay? I know the agony and frustration you went through to provide for me. Mama, don't worry. I'll do this all by myself. I will try so hard to make it happen.
How will you do it? Hi, God. But why would the government increase the examination fee to 12,000 naira? What do they want commoners like me to do?
Mama, listen to me. The world is trying so hard to break us. But we will never be broken, okay? We will never be broken, Mama.
Mama. Potano mole sabini gwe fitamanya anya mire juwo manya uli sabini gwe fitamanya ifi bawo bina bawa mobi onye ni gwe zo bandigi okwa gibutim ne bere okwa gibutim na okuo biaba potano mole sabini gwe zo bandigi.
Mama, it's okay. It's fine. It's okay, Mama. Mama, it's okay. It's okay.
Who's that girl? Who's that girl that is carrying a sound like that?
Oh, her name is Chinasa. She came this morning and said she wants to work.
Because she says she wants to work, that's why you have to allow her to carry sand in the bucket on her head?
Sir, according to her, today is her first time. But she's already doing better than most of our experienced laborers.
You know what? I'm not okay with this, okay? Go and call her for me.
Okay, sir.
I think I'm going to give you any money when you're resisting me this way. I'm a man that makes my money the hard way. And I'm not going to give my kobo to anyone who is not ready to expunge religion from the actuality of life.
Chief, my late husband was your friend.
That's the more reason you should listen to me. Nah. You're a widow. Your husband is late. That means you're simply not living for anyone. Look, play the wise politics. Use what you have to get what you want.
Chief, I am not telling you to give me money for my personal use. We want to use the money for Chinasa's final registration. Please help us.
We're saying the same thing. You want the money, and I'm going to give it to you. Huh? So, just oblige me. You are not going to lock your body forever. Give me what I want. I'm not going to ever tell anybody. It's going to be between us. Come on.
Chief, you made passes at my daughter, and now you're making passes at me. Why are you doing this to the family of a man who was loyal to you all through his life?
As long as you are not giving me what I want, you will continue to expect that money, because it's not going to fall from the trees.
Chief, it is just 12,000 naira that I'm asking from you. If we don't pay that money, Chinasa will not be able to take that exam. Please help us.
See, in this office I have over 2 million naira. 2 million! And I can give all of that to you. Just like that. 12,000 naira is nothing. It's chicken change when I can give you 2 million right now. See, your daughter is not ready to bail you out. But you're here. So just allow me to allow me to take the thing and you have all the money in the world you want. Eh?
Chief. Some ladies can do what you're asking me to do because they don't have conscience and they don't regard adultery as sin. But Chief, I am different. I live for God, and I know that God will not abandon his people. Even if he abandons me, I still cannot sin against him.
Lucinda. Lucinda, listen to me. I think it's wrong for you to refer to this thing as adultery. It's not adultery. You're a widow. And your body is yours. You're free to use it. See, Chief Olulia is a man that is sitting on a mountain of money. Just give me this. And I'm going to change your life forever.
A man nothing like you cannot change my life. I live for God because He is the source of my life. Chief, your money is like rags before God. I want you to know that I have the mark of Christ in me and you cannot lure me to sin. Thank you very much for everything. Thank you.
Money makes the world go round. Money does not come from top of the trees. As long as they do not give me what I want, I will not release any kobo to anybody. My life.
The science engineer told me that payments will be based on work.
Sir, can I go back to work? And why did you call me?
Is it my name is Sylvester, and my friends called me Sly. I'm the owner of this place. And I've been wondering to myself, why is it that you have decided to do such an odd job?
I'm about writing my final exam to get into the technical college. I have not registered for the examination. The registration will close very soon, and I need to take the examination. That's why I'm here working, sir.
What if I may ask, is there no other way you can raise this money apart from you doing such a job? I mean, it's not healthy for any woman.
Sir, I don't have any option. That is why I'm here working to raise money to write my final exam. And if I don't write the examination, I will not enter the technical college.
So what of your family members?
Why are you asking me all those questions? Why?
Okay, I just want to know. That's all.
My family members don't want to help me. So that's why I'm here working.
Why?
Sir, listen, it's getting dark. I have to go back to work. I have to raise money to write my examination, sir. Please, let me just go back to work, sir. Please.
Okay, with no offense, okay? Sweetie, you see, this is life. Things happen. Alright? Whatever that made you decide to do such an odd job, I mean, it must be serious. You could talk to me. Tell me the reason. Tell me the reason your family, friends, nobody wants to help you.
Well, my father told his family members before he died that he wouldn't want his wife to go through the mourning process of wearing black and shaving off her hair. So when he eventually died, they asked her to do those things and she refused. So this is all my father's property that he left behind.
Wow. Wow. Unbelievable. Jeez. Where are you from?
Why are you asking me all these questions?
I just want to know, where you from? Where you from?
I'm from Opaku.
Opaku? Jesus Christ, I can't even believe it. I mean, men over there can be this wicked. How could it be so heartless? I can't just get it, you know?
Sir, please, can I just go back and start working? I mean, it's getting really dark and I have to make up money to pay for my examination.
How
please,
let me
just... Why are you asking me all those questions?
How much is your registration?
My registration is 12,000 naira and 16,000 naira for late entry. Mm. Sir, can I just go back now and start working?
It's all right. You can go back to work.
Yes,
Sir.
Yes?
I can't believe what just happened.
You mean you gave that girl that whole money just like that?
Well, you see, I have no other option but to help. I was once in her position when I was in Kuwait. And I was helped. I got helped by a widow. Few days after I made some money, I decided to go back and show my gratitude to this widow. Just to find out that she was dead and was buried the preceding day. And ever since, I've been looking for an opportunity that I can pay back what this widow did for me.
But the girl you just gave money is not from Kuwait. She's from this country. And I wouldn't be surprised if she's lying and pretending. All these girls that stay there are just pretenders and liars. You'd have asked me, I'm the one that stays there.
My dear site engineer, listen. Let that be my headache. But learn something from me today. Learn to render help to others. For others to render help to you. Okay? Have a good day.
I'll allow you to leave this place.
Look, is there any way you can tell this idiot, this fool, that I would not like to be prophet?
Kwetike, you are an idiot. A very, very big idiot, that's what you are. Moreover, if you get provoked, what will you do? Kwetike, you are not leaving here until I win back all my money. Then I said I'm through for the day, can't you understand something? What the fuck is wrong with you?
What if we keep playing and he keeps winning? Mama, today is not just your lucky day and you need to behave like a big gambler that you are. What's wrong with you?
As far as I'm concerned, both of you are talking nonsense.
Get it down together and we'll finish it here.
Mama, let us keep this gambling.
Ebedike!
Come back here.
Ogedike.
Confirm that shit now, confirm!
Guy, forget it!
rapu se chuku mama rapu oli sanke binigwe giwe sifenine biazo bamwagi enwegi mti ozo onwere bozom neje nimeji obakam no biazo bamwagi enwere bozom neje nimeji obakam no nimeji obakam no biazo bamwagi o enwegi mti ozo
Why are you crying? Eh? Oh, Ginenu, why are you crying?
Why have you abandoned us? When our hope is in you, why?
What is it? What happened? Stop crying now. What happened? Eh? What happened?
He took pity on me when I told him my story. He gave me 25,000 naira and the thief took it away from me.
Somebody gave you 25,000 naira and thieves took it from you. How do you mean? I don't understand. Eh? I don't understand.
Why are you trying to provoke me? You asked me to come on the 19th and collect my money. Today is 19th. Why are you not paying me? Why are you playing games with me?
I just asked you a question, which up till now you haven't answered. What am I paying for?
All wrong here. Don't remind me of the things I have forgotten. Are you paying me or not?
I owe you nothing. And I will surely not pay what I don't owe. If there is anything you think you can do, better start now.
Those who kill and walk away will someday have a reason to run when they kill those who are more grounded than them. Although you have touched the tail of a tiger and you will meet with me at the junction where you will cry for mercy and none will come for your rescue.
Come back. Fool, if you think there is anything you can do, get out! Get lost.
Hello, sir. I'm on duty, sir.
If you ever let that Alice cross that gate ever again, I will deal with you. I make myself clear.
Yes, sir.
Madam, you seem to be having a problem with my boss. Do you mind telling me what the problem is?
Alice Benson, the Iron Lady of Cable 4, is too elevated to discuss characters like Oluo Olie. He thinks he has arrived, but I will surely prove to him that masquerades do not dance forever. Open the gate.
This one that everybody is talking tough. I hope no problem.
I am so surprised that you're bothering yourself over what doesn't concern you.
Of course it doesn't concern me. But the truth is, it's a clear indication of injustice. And men who pray for justice should not allow glaring injustice to go unchallenged.
You are not from Mapako. Why are you disturbed with what happened in Opako?
Oh, must I be from Opako before I can challenge injustice? Is that what you're saying? Why are you sounding as if you're not bothered? Why? Do you know what it means for you to seize everything a man left with his family, and then this same family turn out to be beggars?
Sly, as you grow in life, learn to be consigned with only what affects you personally. Don't go about poking your nose into other people's affair. Men that tried it never liked the experience.
The thing was a very simple thing. This girl walked into my sight. She came to work for money. Money to do what with money? She needed this money to pay for her registration for her final examination. That's it. And I mean, a girl like that shouldn't have problem with funds for academics. Why men are so wicked lately?
Listen to me. We are not from Opako. Why don't you leave Opako people to solve their problems?
Yes, engineer, how are you?
Someone actually thinks that you're Father Christmas or possibly a drunk billionaire that doesn't know what to do with his money. What do you think?
I sincerely don't get that.
The same girl of Akpako, who you gave a whooping 25,000 naira, came with some tales of having lost the money to some hoodlums that wanted to rape her. I don't just know.
Oh, quite unfortunate. Jesus Christ, I hope she didn't get raped in the process.
I don't get it, sir. Are you telling me you believe her cock and bull?
Now, what do you mean by cock and bull?
That low-class girl from Akpako actually believes that we are fools with no brains. But I've already made it clear to her that we are no fools here.
Where is the girl right now?
She should be on her way back to where she came from. Yes, I actually ordered her out from the site, and I was very decisive when I gave that order.
Did what? Now listen to me, engineer. Do you know what you do for me? Go and find that girl, whatever she is, and bring her back to that site and tell her to wait for me. I'm on my way there.
I don't get it, sir. Why would you say a thing like that? What would you be doing with her?
Do not provoke me with your useless question. Do you understand me? I repeat, go and find that girl, bring her back to the site, and tell her to wait for me. I'm on my way there. And let me tell you something. If I get to that site, I don't see that girl, I swear to God, you would not like my actions. Do you understand me?
I can't say I know what is going through that head of yours. But let me warn you, do not have anything whatsoever to do with a woman from Opako. Women from Opako are very possessive. As soon as you have anything to do with a woman from Opako, you will lose your freedom because she would want to know everything that you do.
Well, I'm not planning anything with the lady. I just want the right thing to be done.
don't be offended. Can I have a word with you?
Yes. Hold on.
Something happened and I want to take you back to site.
Listen, I don't know why you want me to go back there with you. But the truth is that I don't want to go back there with you.
Hello, excuse me.
There's something you're not getting here. I'll be in trouble if you don't follow me back to site.
You'll be in trouble? How?
My boss is angry that I dismissed you the way I did. So he has ordered me to trace you back. Please, come with me. He wants to give you the money again.
Listen, it is getting very late, okay? I can't walk back to the site and trek all the way to Opako. I mean, I don't want darkness to catch up with me. I don't want to walk back home late.
Oh, it's like you didn't hear me. It's like you didn't hear me well. Eh? My boss is a nice man. And I know he wants to give you the money again. He will give you the money. Eh? As for trekking back to Opako, I'll tell him to give you money to take a bus.
Listen, it is possible that the good man sent for me. But you know what? I honestly do not believe what you just said now.
You don't believe me? Eh? Do you think I can trace you to this lonely road that leads to Opako just to come and say something that does not exist? Eh? Who the hell do you think you are?
You see, you're already getting angry with me. I know that I'm not qualified to make you angry. So please just leave me alone and I want to go back home, please.
Why have you chosen to be such a fool? Listen, mark this. If you miss this opportunity, don't blame anybody. I know my boss. He wants to give you the money again.
European guys with their eyes for good things. This girl is not as timid and local as I thought, though.
In Las Vegas, stays in Las Vegas. It is remarkable that you left the city of sin with something close to the steps of dance goddesses of planet Hollywood.
I'm very happy you like it. I actually learned that because of you.
For me? You see, Bolingo is not the kind of man that women deceives with lines. I think it's about time you told me why you're here. Say it.
My dear Bolingo, that's too harsh. As far as I'm concerned, we're enjoying the best of our times.
Really? And your willingness to do all that I want is very suspicious. Hmm? I know you too well, Alice. I know you too well. You're not the kind of girl that is easily bent. Remember the last time you played with me, last April? Since then, you have refused to come close to me. For you to suddenly reappear from God knows where, out of the blues, and you're here willing to do all that I want you to do. That is too easy for comfort. So spill it.
You know I like you. You are very, very smart. You read meaning into every line and every word.
I will not be the hitman of the mafia of Suxedo if I don't have those qualities. You're here today, very free with me, firing me from both cylinders, giving me the down steps of the VIP wing, just because you want me to do something for you. Say it. What is it? Sit down.
I'd rather come sit with you. You know I've missed you.
You're just saying it.
A man who should not play games with me has elected to play games with me. And I want you to turn him off.
Bolingo will always be Bolingo. Who is this man?
Promise me you will turn him off.
I don't make promises when I'm not sure that the necessary information are fully available. So who is this man you want me to turn off?
Why you're angry with me? I ran after her like you instructed, got her, she was trekking back to Obako, delivered your message, but she says she doesn't believe me.
Of course she didn't believe you. Because why? Because of the way you delivered the message to her. Simple. Oh, Jesus Christ, I can't just believe it. I don't know, when will you learn how to be gentle with people?
I saw that girl when she was walking off, and I realized that she wasn't as local and timid as I had always taken her.
I really didn't get that.
I know you understand me, sir.
No, I don't. I don't understand you. What do you mean by you the way you've taken her? She's really not local and timid as the way you've taken her.
Okay, do you actually believe that she was related by some hoodlums?
Oh, why won't you believe her? Why? You just confirmed here now. You said that you saw this girl tracking back home. Common sense could have just told you that this girl was robbed and she needed help.
That might be the reason why I've not made money yet. Because I find it difficult to believe people.
Well, that's your own cup of tea. Now listen to me. I'm going to leave some money with you, okay? And in case this girl comes back, make sure you give her that money. Do you understand me?
Yes, I do.
Now, take a piece of advice from me. Always realize, in helping strangers, you stand a chance of helping angels unknowingly.
You're the boss, and I'm learning from you.
You should have boss here. Learn it. I told you this before.
Chinasa. Is there something you're not telling me? Because you've been so quiet since you came back. Is there any problem?
Mama, I should have listened to him.
Who is the him that you failed to listen to?
The site engineer. He called me back after dismissing me. He said that the site owner wanted to see me. I presumed that he knew that I came. I did not go back. I wish I listened to him. I wish that I went back to see him. But I didn't.
You see, Chinasa, when certain things happen, I try as much as possible to look closer. I am beginning to think that God did not really want you to take that exam.
Why would you say such a thing? Mama, we are serving the living God. He's a faithful God. He watches over his people. He can never abandon us in our time of need. He can never do that.
I am so happy that your faith is strong. Chinasa, it is so clear that all the doors have been closed against us. And right now, I don't even know where our help will come from.
I'm so surprised to finally realize that you can go to this extreme when provoked. Chief Ololi was a man you once confessed to me that you loved. And now he's still the same man you want me to kill.
Ololi has proved to me he's got no conscience. And I also want to prove to him that I know more than he knows.
In a circle of Sugzada, we don't believe in the outright elimination of a man.
But you can't afford to disappoint me. You are my hope. And believe me when I say, I want you to deal with him.
I never said I'll disappoint you. All I'm saying is that there are several ways to humble a man without killing him. Just like the saying that says, there are several ways to kill a rat in a clay pot without breaking the clay pot.
What other way do you have in mind? Because I want you to bring Ololi to a point where he's going to feel severely hurt, where he will be alive and be seeing his funeral. He has touched me in the center of my life, and I want you to touch him where it matters most.
We're saying the same thing, but in different dimensions. You have told me what you want, and I've assured you that I'll do it. So why don't you allow me to handle it?
Thank you, baby.
I'd rather not we go there. The kind of man that you can humble with words or this flighty attitude. Good night.
So do not take your eyes off the sight.
Okay, sir.
I hired you because I trust you. So do all you can and make sure you maintain that trust I have for you.
Okay, sir. Like I said, work will not be delayed and no materials will be wasted. You have provided all that we needed. There is simply no reason why we shouldn't deliver.
Very good. That's nice. That's very nice. I gave you a call when I get to Abuja. All right?
I'm waiting for your call, sir. But please drive safely.
Okay. It's all right. It's all right. Ahan, remember, if that indigent girl comes around, give her the money that I gave you for her. All right? Tell her that she should continue her hard work and secure her future. Tell her that I said hard work pays.
I'll remember. Let's pray she comes back, sir.
Good.
Okay, sir.
Okay,
then. Okay, sir.
Take care of it.
Okay, sir.
Yeah.
Thank you.
You said you don't believe me. What are you doing here?
Sir, I'm here to apologize to you for what happened yesterday. I realized that I misbehaved. You know, I couldn't even sleep at night because I was feeling so much pain about it. So I'm here to apologize and know if I can likely see him.
If not for one thing, I won't have listened to you.
I'm sorry, sir. I'm very sorry.
Just wait around here for me. I'm coming. Let me attend to these people at the site. I'll take you to the bus.
Thank you, sir.
Timothy,
Chief.
Timothy, I want you to be specific. What do you want me to do?
This is a new one. You see, the government has realized that the masses are very peaceful and will never engage in any form of violent demonstrations. You see, and that's why they are capitalizing on this and milking this country to zero.
You know, I'm not a politician, and I don't like to dabble into political matters. What is in this for me?
See, I've known you to be a thorough businessman, Chief. There is a real opportunity for us to make money. I want you to look at it closely.
I've been looking at it. Still, I don't get it completely. I don't. How do we make money out of this?
You see, I know you have money. And from this, more money is coming. You see, we are going to set up a refinery in Gabon. And from there, we'll send back refined crude to the country.
I hope you know that the people that do oil business in Nigeria is a cabal that actually does it. And this cabal is deadly. They don't want anybody into what they're doing. How are you going to handle the cabal?
Chief, I'm happy you've identified that there is a cabal. But you need not be afraid, because the presidency has handled it. You see, the government does not want its efforts to be sabotaged by this set of people. And that's why they've had it dismantled. Our organization comprises men in top government positions. You need not be afraid. The coast is clear. And I want you to partner with us. And if you look closely, you'll find out that I've taken very good care of this.
Sorry, excuse me. What is going on here? Where is Mr. Sly? Why did you bring me here? Why have you locked the door?
Calm down. I realize that I have problems.
Sir, why have you locked the door? Why did you lock the door? Why?
You came back here because you are in dear need of money. And the man you came to see has gone back to Abuja.
If he has gone back to Abuja, why did you bring me here?
I brought you here because I knew you need money. And I want to give you more than enough. I brought you back here because I looked at you closely and I realized that you're not as inferior as I initially took you to be. There is something unique about you, and I wanted to start something unique.
Sir, I don't want to cause a scene here. I've seen that you live in a very decent neighborhood. I don't want your neighbors to see you as a rapist. Sir, open this door. I want to live here right now.
Just take it easy. This is 40,000 naira. It will not cost you anything. I'll give you this money so that you can go and solve your problem. But first, you allow me to explore the woman in you.
Sir, I want this meeting to end, and it's going to end right now. Sir, I don't need your money. Come on, open this door.
Why are you such a terrible pretender? You need this money to solve your problem. And what I'm asking will not cost you anything.
Sir. I'm going to shout now. I'm going to shout. Your neighbors are going to hear it. I'm going to shout. Come on.
Come on. Come on.
Remember, if that indigent girl comes around, give her the money that I gave you for her. Alright? Tell her that she should continue her hard work and secure her future. Tell her that I said hard work pays.
Why are you misbehaving again? This is the money I asked me to give to you.
Who asked you to give me the money?
My boss. He left for Abuja this morning. He was just driving off while you were walking in. This is the money he asked me to give you. It's 40,000 naira.
Wait. I don't understand. He provided this money for you to give it to me. I want you to use as a bait to defile me. God, why are men evil? Why do you want to block the blessing going for someone else? Listen, at least
hey, take this money! How dare you call me evil? Take this money and get out from my sight. And if you ever see me, pretend as if you never met me.
It's okay, it's so clear that God is angry with us. But it is well. I know that his anger lasts for a moment. Tears may flow.
Please help me.
Nansa, why do you behave as someone who is slow in understanding? Registration is closed.
He ended his last week. And for your information, I forwarded all the names of the registered candidates to the Board of Examination. I don't know. I don't know what you want me to do.
I beg you, please. If there's anything you can do for me, please don't do for me. I beg you in the name of God, please.
Sir, I am ready to pay you more, please.
If there's anything you can do for me, please just do for me, I beg you.
Well, there's surely no way you could be part of a forthcoming examination. Everything about it has been concluded. And what prospective candidates are doing now is anticipating the date of the examination.
Oh God, why am I this unlucky? Sir, why am I this unlucky? Why will it end now that I have the money? Why?
Listen, listen. I'm not in any position to answer all those questions. All I know is that we are done with registration. And there's absolutely nothing you and I can do about it.
I beg you, please. Just try and do something. I beg you, please. Just help me, eh? Thank you very much, sir. I'm leaving.
All rules have exceptions.
I don't understand what you mean by that. I really don't understand, sir.
You know, I wouldn't be asking. But I'm very sure that you know what happens when a man takes a woman to a hotel.
I'm so sorry. I really don't understand what you mean by all rules have exceptions.
No, sir. Registration is closed, but I can register you today. Yes, all you need to do is come with me to a hotel.
God, why is this always happening to me? Wait, excuse me, sir. Did you say that she come with you to her hotel before you can register me?
Apparently, it's the only condition. If you agree, I would give you the last form I have here. And depending upon how you cooperate, I'll take your phone personally to the board of examination. The choice is yours.
Sir, I have so much respect for you. How could you do this to me? I mean, why?
It is not always my character to want to accept to do this. I'm only doing this because I like you. And I want to help you.
Sir, if you really want to help me because of God. Help me because you really want to do it. Don't allow the devil lure you to sin. Don't allow it!
It is clear to me that you don't want to afford yourself this simple opportunity of taking what you have to gain what is fundamentally important to your life. I'm asking you now, leave my office.
God, why is this always happening to me? Why did they always want to sleep with me before helping me? Why?
Get out! Out, I say! I have no reason to take pity on a fool who would capitalize on a given opportunity. Foolish.
Amo ke mamu adege mundu
Why is this happening to me? It's like everyone has abandoned me. Nobody wants to help me. Doesn't mean that God has abandoned me.
Oga, from the look of things here now, the engine is damaged. It's very, very, very bad.
Do you ever understand what you're saying? I drove this car this morning to this place. How can you tell me that the engine is very bad?
Oga, I know it may be too hard for you to understand, but that is the truth. See now, the cylinder has been affected and the engine is very, very bad. So the best thing we can do is just to change the engine entirely. But I can still work it though. If you want me to work it, I can just do it now. But it's not advisable. So the best thing we can do is to change it, because if I work it, it will still be stopping you from one place to another. So the best thing is just to change the engine entirely.
This is difficult to understand. Very difficult to believe. I drove this car to this place this morning. What is happening?
Well, Oga, you're even lucky that your engine is one of those you can even get at beck and call. So if you just need it, I can just call them now. They just send it here right now. Or should I call them?
There is something I want to get from you. Are you saying that you took your registration money to Roland and he refused to register you?
Yes, ma. He refused to register me. He said that the registration process has ended. He said that he has submitted the final list to this board. And if I want to be registered, I must fulfill his condition, and that is taking me to a hotel.
But why did you register when others were registered?
My mother could not afford it. I had to work very hard as a laborer to raise the money. I am very sorry, ma, for the late registration. But I know that if I sit for the examination, that I will pass. I just want to be registered.
All right. Come with me. Come on. Come on.
Sylvester is always freely giving out money and other things to people, and everything is always working out well for him. In my case, I am always taking advantage of people, and nothing ever works out for me.
If you provide this money for you to give it to me, I want you to use as a bait to defile me.
God, why am I evil?
She was right. I am suddenly facing sorrows and sadness. I had the opportunity to do the right thing. Why didn't I do it? Why?
Sir, I came here to know if you've changed your mind. I want to register for this examination, and I will not be fulfilled if I don't take part in this last examination.
Talking about fulfillment, my dear. If you would listen to me, I will tell you that your fulfillment lies in your hands. Listen, my offer still stands. If you follow me where I want you to follow me, I'll register you immediately and forward your details to the examination board.
Sir, this is unethical. How can someone that works in the public office be doing this?
So what are you doing here? What are you doing back in my office? You left here yesterday, having me on an impression that you have arrived. So what are you doing back here?
Sir, I
came back here to ask you to tamper justice with Mercy. I was at the examination board and I was told that you can help me if you want to.
Are we not saying the same thing? Are we not saying the same thing? I can register you, yes.
But I'm gonna do it for free. Listen, you must do what I want you to do before I do what you've already confirmed that I can do. The choice is yours.
Girl called Chinasa Ike.
Chinasa Ike.
Yes.
Ike. Chinasa. Chinasa Ike. I'm not sure I've come across such a person. No. I don't remember.
Okay. Chinasa Ike was the girl who came to be registered for her final examinations with you. And you told her that the only way forward is for her to sleep with you. Are you saying you never said a thing like that? Are you?
Madam, you are the boss. You are the boss in this establishment. And I believe that your experience is vast here. With all due respect, ma, I believe by now you should know that people are fond of making baseless allegations, unfounded accusations against staff that are well positioned in this establishment, just to make a mockery of them. Madam, look at me. Denying Roland demands sex from a helpless girl before I register her for her final examination. You know this is not the standard here. And everybody knows that I am the man of standard.
You see, liars like you are the reason why I go to the extreme to get my evidence before I do anything. Are you telling me they never made a set demand on the helpless girl that came to your office last Thursday?
Madam, I don't know what you're talking about. Honestly, I don't know what is happening here. I don't know what you're talking about. Let me clarify issues. See, on this very Thursday, I can remember vividly that I closed from office early. And I can categorically say there was no woman, let alone a girl, that visited my office on that Thursday.
Really?
Yes. Listen, my offer still stands. If you follow me, where I want you to follow me, I'll register you immediately. And forward your details to the examination board. Madam, this is my voice actually. I don't deny it. But please, what happened is not what you think. Don't put my words out of context. I can explain, madam. I can explain.
You owe us no explanations, Roland. Get your lawyer and brief him accordingly. You are going in for assault, an absolute abuse of public office. Do you understand that?
Madam, he hasn't come to this extent. He hasn't come this far, madam, please.
don't tell me that this is happening. I give that man $3 million. He can't just disappear like that. He can't. I don't know why you are sounding like you don't have brains at all. What does that mean? Insult?
No, I'm not insulting you. But you are saying he can't just disappear like that. Whereas, he has disappeared already. See, let me tell you. Timothy has defrauded you. He has defrauded you. And that is all they do in that their network of Susuda.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute. Are you trying to tell me that Timothy has a link with the international mafia network of Susuda? Eh?
Having a link is basic to qualify his involvement. Timothy is Bolingo's right-hand man. And Bolingo is the hitman of the Susudas. If you are sure that you gave them $3 million, I have to advise you on time to forget the money, because you will not get it back. And you will not do anything. You will not be able to do anything about it.
This is unbelievable. What am I going to do?
I don't know. I don't know. I'm simply a businessman doing my things lawfully. I am not a mafia. I am not a criminal. I'm just a businessman. You can see, that's me.
Solo, Timothy is your friend. So you are going to help me to track him down. I've been calling all his lines and he's not been picking. What do I do?
You can't say that. You can't say that Timothy is my friend to mean that he's close to me. He's my friend just as you are to me. I don't have any contact with him. I don't have any business with him. I don't have any cordial relationship with him. That's all.
This is indeed a critical situation. The plan was to partner with him and set up a refinery in Gabo. Oh my God. I'm on the verge of bankruptcy.
He's called me more than a million times. And I know that by now he would have started to suspect that all is not well.
Your boyfriend is not as smart as I thought he was. What can he do?
No. Is that what you think? That he's my boyfriend?
You are actually deviating into nonsense. And I sincerely do not have time for rubbish. The question is, what can he do?
Well, I don't know. But I don't think it's wise for him to stop picking his call.
The man, Solo. How are you today?
I'm cool, I'm cool. Timothy, where are you now?
I don't know why you want to know my location.
Are you hiding from someone or what? Why would you have a problem with my asking you of your location?
Who are you there with?
I am in the office. I am alone. Why do you ask?
I don't believe you. And I don't know whom you've been talking to and why you want to know my location.
Timothy, I have this feeling that you are up against some forces. And you are being very careful. Open up to me. I am your friend. What are you not telling me?
Tell him.
Tell him that credible men do not look down on women. Because women make the world go round. All the men that ultimately got destroyed for their carelessness were destroyed by women. And now that he has pitched his tent against a more powerful woman, he's suddenly down and grounded.
Who are you talking about?
Don't pretend like you don't know what I'm talking about. We are the men of the mafia of Susoda. We know what happens in this town. But tell the man that hired you for this call that since he has placed himself in an elevated position, let him lick his wounds.
You heard what he said? I suspect you are up against a woman.
Those who kill and walk away will someday have a reason to run when they kill those who are more grounded than them. Oluwole, you have touched the tail of a tiger and you will meet with me at the junction where you will cry for mercy and none will come for your rescue.
Could she possibly be part of this mafia of Susoda?
Who is this woman?
Oh. What have I gotten myself into? Why didn't I give her the money? The money that was her due anyway.
You are confusing me the more. So you sat on something that belongs to a woman? Who is this woman?
Credible men do not look down on women because they know that women make the world go round. What manner of statement is that?
Yeah, Alex, you are saying something about not picking his calls. What's that all about?
I'm sure you know what I meant. You see, men who control the affairs of the state are not afraid of anybody. Talk of the devil. There he goes calling. One thing I learned from my late boss is that men are never really down until they are down for real. I know the meaning of that statement, and that's why I'm following you with extreme caution.
Where are you this minute as you speak?
Well, you're asking my location because you surely want to see me. Now tell me, Chief Oluwole, what makes you think I want to see you?
Are you in any way related to this network of Susoda?
Well, I am not only related to the mafia of Susoda. I am the lady that lubricates the body. You're sounding as if you've been touched by Susoda. Kindly tell me, please.
Please, can you meet me in my office in the... I'll be in my office in the next 40 minutes. Why don't we meet then?
There is one thing I want you to get clear. You will never see me in your office again.
See, whatever. There is an issue on ground and you may be affected eventually. Why don't you come to my office and we'll thrash it out?
There is nothing to thrash out, Chief Oluwole. You treated me like a trash because you think you've probably arrived. I told you that you will be sorry and you thought I was joking. You thought I was ranting. Realize that I will never come to your office. And if you try anything funny, I sure will thorn you off.
Alice, are you threatening me? Chief Oluwole of Opako, are you threatening me?
You are nothing. You better start now to lick your wound because you are grounded.
Imagine that. Things I have that time. Drop your hoop, so.
Mama.
Eat.
Mama, this examination is my life. I see that they build up to my future, Mama. I don't want to play with it. Let me just read.
No. Eat, oh. The books are not running away. Eh? Empty stomach is not good for you. Eat. Don't worry. God has decreed that you will pass this exam. Oh?
Thank you. Hey, Mama. I heard that Roland is in jail. Well, I didn't know that what he did could land him in jail.
How can you talk like that? Oh, you think you were his only victim, okay? He must have been doing it on other girls. God has finally caught up with him.
No, Mama. Mama, I feel guilty about it though.
Guilty?
Yeah.
Makagin.
I feel I'm the one that landed him in jail now.
Chinasa, don't talk like that. Eh? The Bible says every sin has its punishment. So don't just let your conscience bother you. Oh, you didn't do anything.
Mama, seriously, I feel very guilty about it. Everybody started looking at me and I'm the one that caused everything.
Ngwangwa, eat. Drop that topic.
Okay. I feel bad, sir.
Bible says, prepare you the way of the Lord and make his path straight. Why are you allowing the spirit of sin to manifest in you? It's only those that have the spirit, the Holy Spirit in them, who see Jesus in his glory on that fateful day. Give your life to Christ. Give your life to Christ. My brother, there is no time. You are nothing without the spirit of the risen Christ. Showing kindness to people will not take you or anyone to heaven, but the kindness you show will be registered in your favor. My brother, those things you put in your cupboard, you think they can protect you, I tell you that last day, they will fail you. They must surely fail you. To those that believe, he gave the power to be the sons of God. Believe, my brother. Believe, my sister. There is no time left for us. There is no time for us. Give your life to Christ. Tomorrow may be too late. Don't wait until tomorrow comes.
A mere mortal like you cannot change my life. I live for God because he is the source of my life. Chief, your money is like rags before God. I want you to know that I have the mark of Christ in me and you cannot lure me to sin. Thank you very much for everything.
Could it be? Could it be that my refusal to help this widow and her daughter is responsible for all my predicaments?
Mama, I'm ready.
God will write this exam for you. He is going to be with you as you go and as you come.
Amen.
You will write and you will be successful in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Go, my daughter. Hmm?
Thank you, Mama.
I wish you success. Hmm?
Okay, Mama.
Make me proud.
I have read my book.
Make me proud.
I've read.
Over.
There is a Volkswagen Vento driving towards Isiagu as we speak. It is red in color. They have just attacked some officers and made away with their weapon. Apprehend them now and bring them here. Over. Over. Continue to send signal to relevant checkpoints.
Yes, sir.
Continue.
Yes,
sir.
Rotting in jail if you don't tell me what I want to hear.
Officer, listen, please. I don't know why you brought us here and what I did to you. Officer, please, I'm going for my examination. I beg you, please. I'm going for my examination, please.
Do you think you can deceive me with your lies? You people attacked some police officers and made them away with their guns. So where are the guns?
Guns? What do you mean by guns? You know you're molesting innocent citizens, and that's wrong.
What? So you're not teaching me my job?
No, officer, we are very sorry. We are really sorry. Officer, I'm an innocent girl. And I'm already late for my examination. We took a taxi from the motor park going to Isiagu. Officer, I'm very innocent. I did not do anything.
Officer.
Yes, sir.
Take that statement and detain them.
Okay. Hey, fools! And robbers! You people are going to come after them. You! Step forward. Step forward!
Sir, look at them. They have been claiming innocence since ever, and that is rubbish as far as I'm concerned. They must take me to where they kept the guns.
But officer, these were not the people that attacked us.
What are you talking about? The information was that you were attacked by armed robbers, that you were escaping to Isiagu on a red Volkswagen Vento.
Yeah, of course we give that information, but these people here are not criminals. Their claim of innocence is justified.
That's unbelievable.
Officer, release these people immediately. I don't want problems here. The real criminals are out there. You have arrested the wrong people. Spread out your network and arrest the real criminals. I repeat, spread out your network and arrest the real criminals. Over and out.
Give ear, O Shepherd of Israel. You who lead Joseph like a flock, you who dwell between the cherubim, send forth. Before Ephraim, Benjamin, and Manasseh, stir up your strength and come and save us. Restore us, O God. Cause your face to shine and we shall be saved. O Lord God of hope.
Okay. Hey, Chinasa, what is it? What happened? Eh? What happened? Was the examination too tough and you think you're going to fail? Okay.
Mama, I missed the main examination. I don't think they will even allow me to take other papers.
You missed your main examination. How? Did you get there late or they started too early? Kenko.
Mama,
the police arrested people from the Central Park. They mistook us for robbers that attacked some officers. They took us to their station and detained us for hours. When I got to the venue of the examination, it has been concluded.
Hi, God. God, for how long will you close your doors against us? What have we done wrong? Where have we gone wrong? It's okay. It's okay. It's so clear that God is angry with us. But it is well. I know that his anger lasts for a moment. Tears may flow all through the night, but joy cometh in the morning. It's okay. Let his will prevail in our lives.
Huh? Mama, I went for the examination. I tried my best. I was busy night and day, and I missed the examination again. I missed it.
I know. Chinasa, please don't break my heart. Biko, don't break my heart. It is well with us. Oh, it is well. It is well.
I had always thought that my destabilized state is as a result of my wickedness on the poor girl. Then the preacher finally confirmed it. He said that the girl is the anointed of God. Then he said that God is angry with me. He said I have touched his anointed and I have done his prophet harm. Something tells me that I need to travel to Opako and trace the poor girl, then apologize to her. Ever since I lured her to my place and she walked out on me, everything has gone wrong in my life. My life has never remained the same.
You see, hasn't it boiled down to the same thing I've always told you? The same thing. See, you must learn how to treat people with kindness. Yes. People who did so in the past, they actually got blessed. They didn't even know they were being blessed by angels.
I've learned my lesson. And my only concern is that I learned it the hard way.
Well, that's life for you. The most important thing is that you've learned your lesson very well. And in the future, if you see someone who needs help, you will never hesitate to help.
This house is still okay for us. And I am not tired of you, my daughter.
Mama, I remember what my father said. And I'm now convinced that I'm not supposed to be here. Mama, things are not working out fine for us. Let me go and make a move.
Make a move to where? Huh? It's true that we don't have anything here in Opako, but we have food. Huh? Okay. If you go to the Asaba now you're talking about, what will you be doing there?
Mama, there are a lot of things I could be doing. I wrote my final exam to enter the technical college, but things did not work out fine. Mama, there are things I will be doing in Asaba. Don't worry.
And where will you be staying?
Mama, there are evil people, I agree, but there are also good people. Well, when I get to Asaba, I'll find someone that will give me an accommodation.
Hey, Chinasa. Chinasa, don't tell me that you're going to betray all the moral upbringing I gave to you. Chinasa, don't tell me that you're going to Asaba to live with a man.
Mama, a man? Mama, I cannot do that to you now. After all you've done for me, I cannot betray the family name. I cannot do that, Mama. I can't.
Tell me that when you get to Asaba and things don't work out the way you planned it, that you will come back home.
Mama, I promise you, if I go and things don't work out, I will come back. Don't worry.
Mama, let me be going.
Mama, stop it now.
Kedozia kosi bulumo.
iye ni no wa ni me onagalu muwa mama china se me oko chichira bachite keduzia kosibulu mo kedunu kosibulu mo Eze ni gwebi kolota, lotazia mama chinasa. Keduzia kosibulumo, kedunu kosibulumo, kedunu kosibulumo, keduzia kosibulumo. Eze ni gwe lotanu, lotazia mama chinasa. Eze ni gwe biko lota, lotazia mama chinasa. Chine kenke bini gwe, keduzia kosibulu mo. Iye ni no waneme, onagalu muwa, mama china seme, oko chichira bachite, keduzia kosibulu mo, kedunu kosibulu mo. Eze ni gwe biko lota, lotazia mama chinasa.
Amake mu yemgeme, amake mu ebemgeje, agara mu wanke miche. Chukwuni nebe, amwange mamu adege mundu, wama sefwe.
Chineke jelebe,
menenu ogaraga menala umwerisi.
Chineke jelebe,
afufunu todo apana bani.
Chineke jelebe,
chupu ne mema choro musantino nyere maka.
Chineke jelebe,
chupu ne mema choro musantino nyere maka.
Chineke jelebe. Chineke jelebe,
akwam nebe metunu ginobiyo nyere maka.
Chineke jelebe. Chineke jelebe.
I've not been around, I just got back a few days ago and my site engineer told me what transpired between them. I felt very hot, I mean really, really hot, so I decided to come around and apologize to her and also ask her how the examination went.
That is very thoughtful of you. I really appreciate it. But the unfortunate thing is that she is no longer in our park.
Where is she?
She got so frustrated with a whole lot of things and she decided to leave.
How do you mean she decided to just go? What happened?
She was unable to take the main paper in the technical college exam and was also barred from taking other exams. So she got frustrated and just this morning she decided to go to Asaba.
Wow, this is very confusing. Why was she unable to take the main technical paper?
She told me that on her way to the place, that policemen arrested the bus she was going in, mistaking them for some robbers who attacked or some officers. So by the time they were released, it was already late. She got to the examination center, but they had already finished. So she got frustrated and decided not to continue with school. To be very honest with you, I don't know. But I have already prayed to God to take charge.
As if you're new here.
Why would you say a thing like that?
Look, you shouldn't be in this neighborhood at this time. I presume you're new, and that's why you're still here.
I don't understand what you're saying. What is wrong with this neighborhood?
Look, my dear, as soon as it's 7 p.m., you will see many artisan workers and jobless young men that will come into this neighborhood to smoke in their hand. Look, my dear, they have raped so many girls before.
What? Are you serious? God forbid.
Hello. Look. You need to leave here now. You need to leave now before they meet you here. Unless you're one of those useless girls looking for people to rape them.
No. I'm not. I'm actually not. Thank you so much.
Come, tell me. Where did you even come from?
My name is Chinasa. I'm from Opako. It's my first day in this town.
Tell me, who did you come to see here? I mean, what are you doing here?
Thank you very much.
Come, you look, you can talk to me. I'm a woman like you.
Well, I don't really know anybody in this town. I came here to search for a new life and a new job.
New life, you say? Look, the only new life and new job you can have here is prostitution. Sometimes police do disturb them, but trust me, it has not discouraged them from moving on with that trade. If you are ready, I will take you to where they normally stand.
I don't understand. Wait, I'm sorry to ask you this. Are you one of them?
My name is close to yours. My name is Chidema. I am not a whore. I actually stay with my boyfriend in this neighborhood. I see what happens, and I came to offer you an advice. Look, you need to leave. You need to leave here before you are raped.
Thank you very much. I'm so grateful. Thank you so much. I'm leaving. Thank you.
Yes. This is actually what they want. An innocent girl they can fix them. I can never allow them to succeed. Never. I don't know why you touched my shoulder. Look, my boyfriend stays in this neighborhood. Don't you ever mess with me.
So, you stupidly think I don't know you? Huh? Anyway, for the records, my name is Hero! Hero! And the reason why we have not looked towards this direction is because we know you and your punk ass boyfriend live here. But since you have chosen to be our problem, our own problem, I don't have a choice than to teach you that rape is something every woman must experience. So come here and give him to me.
I promise you. Look at. Damn you, girl.
Why? What are you doing here, uncle? What are you doing here now? What? Why are you doing this to me? Okay, uncle, I promise that I will not tell your wife about this. I will not mention it to her. Uncle, just please just go. Go, I beg you, please.
Do you realize you are living here in my house?